Very good morning, students. So last class we discussed about redundancies. So cliche is today's topic, you know, and they go hand in hand. Cliches and redundancies you need to reduce while writing or while speaking. Okay, so what are cliches? We'll go ahead with this topic today. Now, what are cliches in writing? So a cliche is a word or a phrase that has been overused in writing. Now, for example, it is raining cats and dogs. Okay, so you can also say all that glitters is not gold. There are certain phrases or group of words which are being overused. So they have been outdated. So we are no longer using those words and they are addressed as cliches. Okay, excuse me. Now I gave an example here. Leave no stone unturned. Now he tried all his way and he left no stone unturned. That means all the chances he took, all the opportunities he used to win over something or to get something. So there are certain phrases which have been overused, you know, number of times it's been used and it is no longer in existence. So such terms or such words or such phrases are called as cliches. They become very weak and they are meaningless. Okay. Now going ahead, I gave certain examples, you know, common examples of cliches. As I told you, all that glitters isn't gold. All for one and one for all. Between, read between the lines. We used to use it. Now people are not using it. A stone's throw, which is like, you know, quite near. As light as feather. So there are certain phrases and words which no longer exist. Okay. So such phrases or words are called as cliches. Now, how can we avoid these cliches in our communication, you know, in writing or in speaking, mostly in writing? Okay. Identify the cliched expression or expressions in a sentence. So first of all, when you're writing something or when you read something, you read whether this particular phrase has been used number of times or sometimes, you know, decide whether the expression adds meaning anywhere. So sometimes if you remove that particular phrase, it has some sense. Or if you remove that particular phrase, you can replace it with a particular word. Is it having some sense? So such way you have to avoid cliches in your writing. Okay. Now I presented few examples here. Now you can see the first example. In the present day and age, people are increasingly sharing recipes for healthy food on the internet. Now because of these corona days, you find number of recipes over the food. So in the present day and age, now instead of using that particular phrase, we can just go ahead with nowadays. So you have to use such, avoid such phrases by replacing it with the right word. Okay. So it's a better substitute for the cliched expression in the present day and age, nowadays. The same way, at the end of the day. So instead of saying at the end of the day, finally, ultimately, you know, it is for the individual to decide whether he can have a positive approach to the failures in life. So instead of using cliched expressions or phrases, instead of using group of words, can we substitute with another simple word which has sense? Okay. Now we'll do a small exercise, students. Rewrite these sentences avoiding the cliches used. Now malpractice during the examinations will not be tolerated in any way, shape or form. So why should we use, you know, in any way, shape, will not at all be tolerated itself, it signifies everything. So malpractices during the examinations will not be tolerated. No need to use those phrases or extra words. Okay. Whereas redundancy is nothing but repetition of the same meaning. Now you're extending unnecessarily, adding certain phrases, which is like not at all useful. No need to use them. The movie was an edge of the seat thriller. So instead of using, you know, an edge of seat thriller, you can just say the moving was thrilling. Ravi, who's always an early bird. Now, early bird is a phrase or an expression which has been repeatedly used, you know, every time. Routine. So instead of that, as usual, you can just say Ravi, as usual, submitted his assignments much before the deadline. So cliches you need to avoid, students, while writing or while speaking, especially in writing when you write something, cross-check. Can I avoid this cliche? Can I avoid this expression? Can I rewrite it by using another word? Okay. So we'll do more exercises on cliches and also on redundancies in the next upcoming classes. Thank you, students. Have a good day.